Hello, everyone. I hope you're having a great day. Just breathe. There is like a favorite song of mine that's titled that, and it's about a romance, but I love the concept of breathing. Whether you're talking about a romantic relationship or work or relationship with your kids or your day, whatever, the concept of just breathing. The ability that we have to breathe is such a profound ability. It's such a cool thing. And there's something that happens when you focus on your breathing. And when you make the opportunity to take a conscious breath. We breathe all day long subconsciously. We don't think about it. Our body just does it. It's one of the genius aspects of our body. But what about actually being aware, being conscious of a breath, stopping in the middle of a hectic day or an intense argument with your supposed loved one or your child or coworker or whatever, your best friend? What if you were just to breathe? So relieving. You take in fresh air. You take in oxygen that is out there available for all of us. And what if it were able to do something for your mind and not just your body? What if, as that fresh air comes into your body, you can almost imagine it filling your senses, filling your head and flowing through the rest of your body? What if mentally it were you allowed it to erase the crud that's in your head, in your heart, in your soul? Negativity has such a power to poison us. And even though it can feel good, it can feel invigorating sometimes to hang on to anger, a passion. Any passion can be invigorating. But negative passion can be invigorating in an addictive, poisonous way. So what if instead of holding on to that anger and feeling so justified and vindicated by hanging on to it, knowing that all of our friends would agree with us, oh yeah, you should totally be pissed about that. What if we were to let it go by taking in a deep breath of fresh air, even if you have to walk outside to do it? Sometimes that feeling of going outside, like just after it rained or when it's a really crisp fall day like they are right now, you go outside and you take in that deep breath of fresh air and be conscious about it. Feel it come into your senses, come into your brain and flow through you, through your limbs, through your heart, through your blood veins. Know that it is consuming you and see it wash away all the crud that's in there. The problem with negativity is we cannot escape it. It's out there. You know, we can label anything negative if we really want to. And negativity can be so addictive sometimes in a really weird way that we're looking for opportunities to be bummed, to be upset, to have drama in our lives. And the more we look for it, the more we find it. And it's like this never-ending cycle, like this nasty snowball running down the hill, but it's not snow of pure white variety. It's the kind that's got a bunch of junk in it, twigs and rocks and probably somebody's pee. That's not the kind of thing we want in our brain. We don't want that picking up speed and picking up negative accumulation in our minds and in our hearts and in our soul, because that's what will happen. It's just like if you're injected with venom, it spreads through your body. Well, that's what negativity does. So just breathe. But this time, make it a conscious breath. Really pay attention to it and feel it consume your body. Just like, you know, when it's really hot outside and you drink some cold liquid and you can feel it go through your body, or opposite, on a really cold day and you drink hot liquid. Same kind of thing. Feel it go through your body and wash your body clean of all the crud. And then you just feel so much lighter. Like you can take more breaths that way. It can be addictive in a good way. So focus on the good addiction and allow a breath of fresh air to get rid of the negative addiction. Be happy. Be full of breath. Be full of air. And enjoy your life, which you cannot do hanging on to anger. Take care of you. Have a great day. We'll see you next time.